of bronze in this game is worse than League. It's worse. It's like 1,000 times worse. I thought bronze in League was bad. Oh, pain to figure out later. I wonder how much XP is lost. Let's see how this works against these little suckers. Okay. Let's see how many bosses. Guys, okay. We're doing a semi boss rush. I'm still trying to get this guy to level 40, and from there. At least how many bosses on hard mode. Hard mode is the real challenge. Resistant. I literally resist for every day of his life. Oh, I got him and blocked his revive. Yeah, might as well. I need to level these other guys up more. These are the ones who need it. Spirit powers. How are you doing? That's an unusual thing.
Idiot is rip.
Idiot is on a rampage. An idiot is legendary. Idiot is legendary. An idiot is legendary. Idiot is legendary. That's what it is. Whoa. Oh yeah, we had that problem, but then I conquered it. The reason I'm trying to level these guys, by the way, at least two of them, is not because they're valuable in the usual sense, is that I don't care if they die. So if I can get them in the right position, I can use them to level up the champions I care about. That's the thing. Because the problem is, if I sacrifice a champion that I care about, then I can do it. It messes up your team real bad. So then, like, your whole inner structure of your team is destroyed by doing that. Which is a really painful and difficult thing to come back from. Like, one of the things was, like, when I got rid of the epic dwarf, that ruined my team comp. That guy was so useful. He did so much damage. Yeah, I'm just trying to prepare my first ever rank 4 sacrifice, which we're not far from. Just need to get this guy to level 30. Spirit Host also needs to get to that point. I'm also trying to make up for the fact that I'm still expanding my champion collection. Champion collection is hard to expand. It takes a lot of silver. I mean, a lot of silver. The champion collection I just did takes almost more silver than the gold you currently own. About how much that is. 300 and something thousand silver. Almost the fucking silver. It's a crazy amount. That's part of also why I have to get rid of champions, because they pile up in your inventory and they take up space. And the inventory space is worth silver. It's not worth a small amount of silver either. It's worth a lot of silver. Like, a lot. I still need to have some of them pile up, because some of them are very valuable. Others, I know are not. They go too much effort for the value. Like, they will technically become valuable after a very long time, but that is such a long time away. Like, this Jaeger dude is one of those guys that's like, it's going to take too long for me to get him to the point where he's good. Get the Doom Tower. I still can't get the Doom Tower. All the way to process to leveling up some champs is. And the funny thing is, the higher rank your champion is, the harder it is. start the boss again. I don't think I can fight the termite currently, because I tried fighting the termite earlier today. I made some successes, but the void affinity is still drastic. Actually, no! I actually PB'd. I forgot. I now did 1.4 million instead of 1.3 million. Yep, I actually PB'd. I forgot. Sorry to say that. I'm still a long way from these other creations too, because I don't have a man-eater still. This game just gave me a man-eater instead of another son. Just give me a man-eater. It's not hard. Just give me that chance, please. These morons, we still have to level them up. Because the thing in the end of the day, the reason I'm trying to make him a rank 4 is I'm also trying to make him a rank 5. And then make more rank 5s. Because there is something I need to do. I need to make a bunch of rank 5s and then throw them all into Elham. That's the real chain scheme. Because in the end of the day, Elham hasn't ranked up in a long time. And she needs to rank up somehow. And the only way I can do that is to get a series of rank 4s. Series of rank 5s that I don't care about. And then I have to make 5 rank 5s I don't care about. And then from there, I then leveled up 6. And that will be my first major milestone in this game. Then I'll be finally on the rank, the level of everyone else who plays this game, who has all their 6s in the US. Just the fact that I don't have one level 6 is But then it all starts off with I need a rank 4 process. 4 I don't care about. Right now, there isn't a rank 4 I don't care about. Part of the problem. Well, I kinda don't care for Abyssal, but Abyssal still has like potential potentially. And if only one of those, we need more. Because Abyssal isn't very efficient at his job. Not efficient enough. Does it make any sense? Valerie, though, she's still useful as a healer, etc., so I don't want to get rid of her. Like, I have a reason for almost all of the max levels not to get rid of them. I don't have a reason not to get rid of him. At least he's getting level ups. It's the long process. Maybe such a bitter process. Very interesting. Very nice of you. Still don't have, because they decided to give me a polar bear instead. Or a cold heart. They give me a cold heart either. They give me an Ursa. Like, I know the Ursa is powerful, but what do I do with him? The only way, by the way, to remember this guy quicker is I have to sacrifice my champions. The problem with that is, that's what that means. So, my back. Silver. You guessed it. See, the true agony will try and make a rank 6. Never mind what I'm gonna have to do to get special armor. Another reason you can tell that I'm new is I'm using but some of these champs, though, I'm not intending to keep them, but they're temporary residents. The temporary residents are here to become fuel for her. Fit the fuel for it yet. They're not intent. They're not ready. Not ready. Fight a dragon again. Yeah, here we go. Sounds like great advice. Besides, I don't want to attack it all the time. Because I want upgrades. Silver. I want to have a chance to push my best again. Push my best earlier today. Except for my use of the wizard dude. Needs help of his own. Have enough rank 4s to do it. The problem is that a lot of the rank 4s, I care about what they do. That's the thing. I care about them. If I want to sacrifice to level up people, I don't want to care about that champion too much. That's my problem. Thank you. the amount, the sheer amount of endurance I have to put to get to the point where I am satisfied with what I have to do. What's up? Flame Lancer. Honestly, I don't know. Okay, get some silver. This is what you're missing, by the way, when I'm off screen. You're missing me doing this incredibly tedious process of... Although this is like the finale of it. This is like the finale. This is the tearing end finale of me trying to create a character here. That is powerful enough. Turning him into eventually. While this is a very brutal process, of course. Still don't have the guy with the unkillable bottle. Game gave me a polar bear. Instead. Still so much ahead of it. And the fact that these guys can still get soloed back to play by these dogs is not good. If you want to watch me do like no damage with everyone else, Elhane do like a gazillion damage. This is also for you. But this is literally what you're seeing. The reason that I'm even bothering is because this elf guy, this weird elf guy, he is my first, gonna be my first sacrificial rank 4. Again, I want all these people with crazy buffs and stuff, but I can't get them. The game won't give me that. Go ahead. Yeah, I see. Not like I'm not watching. Death for the final round. Get rid of him, kill him. I have to overvalue him. So, in the meantime, want to know how we're going to speed this up. We are going to go to Silent Champs. Because he is my first, check it out. Again, I don't have any use for him because it's I know he's food. I'm trying to speed up this process of taking this boring elf man and turning him into a food item. Turning out to be incredibly annoying. It feels like one out of every 100 of these damn shots is an actual legitimate thing. That's what it feels like. I don't know whether anyone noticed, but that's what it feels like. Well, he's come a long way. But it's not over yet. I need you guys to really feel my annoyance at how difficult it is to get to this point. I'm going to fight the boss now. Because, again, I need this guy to ascend. And that is proving... Oh, he's doing some damage now. That's good. I'll make it a little less tedious. This is the process. Brutal finale. Trying to speed this process up. I need like better range. I need to know more about this. So I knew more about the game. I think I could do this fast. My real problem. It's a lot. This gets a lot of natural hits in. Good. I need this guy. get to the point where he's actually good. That's the problem. I literally have to do 30 levels at once in order to make this efficient. Which means I have to get beverages, I have to play with them, and I have to get him one shot all at the same time. And I have to try to carry him with Al Hay, which is my primary goal, because nobody else is as powerful as her at the moment on my team. Like, Frozen Banshee's approaching it, but she still needs upgrades. She needs to get it at 5. But, more importantly, Al Hay needs to get it stronger. With that, 6. 6. Is pretty. Oh, it's the bikini squad. The problem is they don't have too many levels for this. They're at max level. The problem is, I'll tell you what the problem is. You only get silver for this, not even two. Believe it or not, you're like, they're level 30, how are they max level? They're only rank 3. That's your answer. I'm not planning to sacrifice any of them because they're the important bikini, remember? In that video? That's part of why I'm doing this in the first place. It's for them. If you don't realize it, because sometimes the stuff I have to do, I have to do it a lot more. I try to make something that isn't them and sacrifice them. So the problem is, you're just kind of sort of sacrificed. They're like gone. That's part of the problem we have. I mean, I need the silver anyway. I need the silver for the upgrade. Things. That's part of the problem. Everything in the game costs silver. It's not like a small amount of silver. It's like a very large amount of silver. Take them to a level where they all have to lose. But the problem with that is I get less EXP. Wish it was more. Because I feel I deserve more than that, but I don't get it. That guy can throw out some fangs, but he's just not. He hasn't been fighting enough to get the levels he needs. Shackle Shark. Champion for that. That's good. That means I can make a sacrificial version of her later if we want. It does not mean I don't have to grind Palace of Arabia. I do, and some other things. Proving to be incredibly difficult. Frustrating! Trying to get someone straight to level 30. Like, I want this like weird shaman. It's hard to do. Fight is taking. See, 1,200 damage would be impressive if this game was like League. League, that would have one shot, potentially. Not here. Which is something that no League champion would typically do. You know? Can I wipe these guys out? This guy, who has this like weird buff system, he transfers the stuff over. It's so difficult to complete this mission. And you think that I have to repeat something like this a lot. It's like, this is where the game gets really wrong. I have to make so many decisions. I have to get people to have buffs. I have to figure out what the buffs do. There's still so much I don't know. Everyone else understands the game better than me. Sucks. Off that, take it. And I'm gonna go for pain. Apparently he takes some of the pain of it, which is annoying. Takes three. Valley of Death available. That point. Beat the Minotaur. It's the grand challenge. Beat the Minotaur. how many times I have to beat the Minotaur before I can get what I need, but I'm assuming it's a lot. And the thing that's dumb is the fact that, even though I have some new champions, it's so difficult to get a new one. And it's even more difficult after getting the new one to make them the proper level and the right gear, etc. Because I've got some really powerful champions now, but making them powerful, getting their levels, understanding what color they need, etc., that's ridiculously hard, actually, it's proven to me. But it's so complicated. All these knights and what perception. I have to still look into how to do the forge as well. I guess 3K. That would one-shot almost anyone in League. This is what I'm up against. That would one-shot almost anyone in League. That is like some damage. Now, it seems like it doesn't seem as much in this game. If you compare it to almost any other game I play, 10K damage is outrageous. The max level spell in Abiant, one, like some of the highest damage, something like 7. They're not even making it. Mission, and I'm sticking to it, even past status effects and death, which is, this is probably the end. But I want everyone to know that it's been very, very hard to try to make this thing. Still want one in the team. Still waiting for the day when, you know, the shard says, "Hey, try a skull clamp, draper, whole heart, or man eater, any of these other champions that everyone has." Not today. I don't even have a Haikatoon. Want a Haikatoon? Can't until 30 days. Feels like an eternity. Say 30 days in this game feels like a year. A virtual year. Well, please. This is the unkillable stuff. I don't. move him to vault regardless. Man, my vault is vast. Someone else. And upgrade. And there you have it. And then I have to level him up. Yeah, I have to level him up again and try to upgrade him again. Or use him to upgrade someone else. That was the first time I've done that, by the way. You are welcome. Today has been an annoying day, but I hope you enjoyed my process of trying to make a champion that's powerful. And later, I will use him with a bunch of other champions.